What's going on, guys? Niko here, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to make bass lines that pop out, that really sound great and energetic, and I'm gonna throw a little melody on for this demo for you. Before we jump in, want to let you know I'm giving away 1,000 melodies royalty free. Comment down below melody mastery. I select one winner every Friday, and make sure you watch this video from start to finish. You do not want to miss out on what we're covering today. So, breaking down this bass line now, what is going on here? How is it catchy? How is it working? What are the elements? The first thing I want to do is talk about the arrangement of the bass line. So this bass line is 8 measures, and whenever we're making a melody or a bass line, it is always important to repeat the same elements, but also spice it up so it keeps the listener engaged throughout the process. And that's what this bass line does really well. Just looking at the first measure right here, we have A1 and then A2 and then A1 and then B1. So what do I mean by all this? Well, if we listen in here, and I shifted this up so it's in the key of A major or A minor, C major, so it's only the white keys. Now, you'll notice this measure 1 and this measure 3 sound exactly the same, which is good. We want that repetition. Measure 2, there's one differentiating note, which is why I call it A2. And then this last one right here, it actually has 9 notes, while these ones only have 6. That's why I give it the classification of B. Now, just looking at some of the tricks that go on in this bass line that make it really good is we have to look at our directional movement. Number one, whenever you're creating a bass line, the number one tip I give, even in melodies, is called octave jumping. You see right here, the first one, we go to A to A. So you take this note and you jump it up 12 semitones, 12 half steps to an octave, and that's what we're doing right here. Now listen to this without the octave jump. That's actually pretty cool. We varied it up a little bit. But I take this, I jump up an octave, and now let's listen. So that octave jump really helps. Now, going into the second measure of our bass line right here, which I call A2, all I did was looked at the scale and said, okay, I have 7 notes to work with here. What can I do instead of repeating this same thing? So in reality, I could take this, copy it, and say, what can I do differently? Well, I can mess around with the notes a little bit. Let me bring this one up a couple. And see. And you kind of have that call and response between the first bass, which just goes down, and then the second measure right here, the directional movement goes back up. And then I repeat it again here. And then this one, guys, honestly, like writing this stuff out, it's through trial and error, but if you play an instrument, if you play piano, it gets much, much easier. Now, jumping into the melody starters here, we are playing in the key of A minor, C major. So whenever I'm looking at this, we have 6-6. And we jump up to the 6 here, 3-2-1. That is a melody starter that you can use. It's a fantastic one, and it just has a nice vibe to it, right? And again, you can take these melody starters, play around with your keyboard, and mess around. So in reality, this melody starter on this one right here, it just goes back up to the E. So it's 6-6-6, 3-2-3. And then it repeats again, and this melody starter right here, I'm not going to talk through right now, but I'll put it up on the screen so you guys can screenshot it or whatever else you want to do. Now, jumping into our second measure right here, these first 3 measures are exactly the same, but something very unique is going on right here. Now, let's listen. And I think you heard it, the... Let me pull up the keyboard real quick. I don't know why it's not showing. Oh, because you got to play it. We played one of the black keys, which... Hey, Niko, we're playing in the key of, you know, C major, A minor. We're not supposed to have any black keys. Well, this is a borrowed note, guys, and I call this the 2.5 note. That is what is used by Avicii and a lot of these artists that have that nice jazzy feel to it. That's what this note actually is. So I'll put the melody starter up there. You can use the 2.5 note, and it's in between the 2 and the 3 of our scale. Again, this is a very good trick. It's a very good hack. It's a lot of gold. So if you're still watching, very good for you. So this is our bass line, right? And I'm using the Oliver pack that's on Splice right now. Check that out. It's fantastic. And I layered a bunch of different layers here. And maybe if you guys want it, I'll make another video breaking down all the sound design behind this. So now that you have a grasp on the bass line, I want to show you the surrounding elements that make it sound really nice. Now guys, one thing I always say whenever we're composing is always subtly bring in different elements, not too many at one time, but you bring in more and more. So if we just look at our drums right here, going into our bass line, I'll play it for you. I'm adding different elements very subtly as we go from our first four measures to our next four measures right here. And this really complements the bass line very nicely. Now you'll look here and say, well, I don't see that much going on. Well, the first thing that we're doing is we have a bunch of one shots. If we just look at our drums right here. And then we bring in this other percussion thing right here, which I have a nice reverb on, as well as another hi-hat loop, again, by Oliver. Now, what I could have done here is I actually could have removed the clap, and that may have made it a bit different and have more focus on the bass line. Now you may be hearing something else going on if you have good ears. Now, a couple other things that we have going on here is we have in our effects bus, we have a lot of white noise just coming up and down, some cymbal transitions, and I have the tone of the key of G minor here. And it's playing right here, this tone by itself. And that just adds a nice ambiance. I also have some white noise, the effects, and you combine this with the drums, and it has a nice surround sound to our bass line right here. We obviously have a solid kick drum. And then the other small things that are going on here is I have a guitar right here that is subtly coming into the track. As you can see, I filter automated it, and if you just listen. And then down here, we have just some pianos and some other instruments. And I'm gonna add a vocal to this too and make it sound amazing, maybe Bruno Mars. We'll have to see what happens. But basically, this is how you write creative bass lines and then how you surround them with different elements, right? Like I have those drone notes, I'm introducing different types of percussion. We have a lot of things going on, but for this YouTube tutorial, I wanna keep it short, sweet, and to the point and give you guys that value that you need. So if you liked this video, like, comment, subscribe, hit the notifications bell, comment Melody Mastery down below. I look forward to seeing your success and the bass lines you're gonna write. Again, guys, it's all about putting in the work, putting in the time, really spending time on your keyboard or in your DAW developing these new ideas. This took me a long time to get to this point where I'm just writing stuff very easily, but you can do it as well. Keep watching the channel, stay tuned, and I thank you for watching up until this point. And until next time, I will see you in the next video.